song.
So, today, we're here with Paul Bagnall, a.k.a. the Paulers, and he's had some interesting and entertaining thoughts and actions over the past few days, and we just thought we'd record them so that everyone can enjoy his antics, perhaps post them on the internet. If you're watching this, then you know they're made up there. Alright, so Paul, you're eating lunch today, and you're eating a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and you, what did you say when you got down to the bottom? You just had, like, a little crust left. I believe what you said was, would anybody like to do my crust?
Well, yeah, because I don't want to leave my trace.
But, like, the crust of the now you say sometimes you do eat the crust.
Tell us about that. Different sandwiches. That's not PB&J.
So you only don't eat the crust on peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Why do you?
I always eat the crust.
I'm not. Are you sure about that?
Back to Paul. So what kind of sandwich would you eat?
Sandwich.
Any other sandwich?
Yep.
Unless it was avocado.
I don't like avocado. By the way, I like avocado.
So
do you like avocado?
I love avocados.
No, you don't.
So, Paul, I was traveling in Los Angeles with you a couple weeks ago, and we stopped in a parking lot so you could take a turn driving the Mustang that we rented.
I was going to drive for like 30 seconds.
Yes, but that was besides the point. What I'm trying to get to is the cops came, right?
Yep.
While you were driving.
For 30 seconds, yeah.
And they pulled you over, and... What did the cop ask you?
Where was I from?
And what was your response?
I was from Ace.
Now, what made you think the cop would know what Ace is?
Because they're located in California, not too far from Los Angeles.
5 hours north, and there's an organization with 30 employees. And you think and it's an acronym. It's not acronym.
I saw I tell him what program.
He said what in your response was ACE.
ACES. I decided to spell it out for just in case.
But you spelled the word ACE. You didn't say American Conservation Experience. Perhaps leading the cop to believe that you volunteered for Ace Hardware, which just would really confuse and irritate a cop.
Well, I didn't get.
You were being an asshole, and you almost got arrested.
I wasn't being an asshole. No, I wasn't.
You were. Everybody agreed.
I still did get arrested. Though.
Yeah, but you could have.
Yeah,
if he felt like arresting you, he could have.
His scare tactics didn't work.
The cop was yelling at you, saying,
he wasn't yelling.
You got something to say to me? You got something to say to me?
Yeah.
And what did you do?
I responded, yeah, I do have something to say.
Did you want to be arrested? Were you tired of hanging out with us and want to spend the night in a jail cell?
No.
Is that it?
No, I was just trying to make,
that's what
I
your
was just
actions
trying to make
were.
A point.
The point was that I have that you have no idea how to respond to a cop pulling you over?
No.
That's all we said.
Well, that was just that one experience.
What about what happened within the first half hour of us being in Los Angeles?
Well, I got robbed.
So, we robbed... Were you robbed at... I got $20 back. Were you robbed at gunpoint? Do you have a knife or anything?
You might have had a gun.
So you just gave him the money without having a weapon. Did he threaten you at all?
No.
So you handed him how much money?
celebrity set.
$40. And what happened after that?
He ran away. You want to chase him down, man.
I remember you telling me that he told you that you were trying to buy marijuana from him, and that he told you to go over to a truck parked in the parking lot and get it out of the passenger seat.
Maybe.
What did the truck say on the side of it? I don't remember word for word, but it was something to the effect of this truck was a property of a hotel cleaning service.
Which also
doubles as a pot dealer. Right?
Some people do that, and I know do that.
You know people who clean hotels and deal pot on the side and use it as a cover?
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, well. On the island? Where were you born?
Martha's Vineyard.
And how many people are in Martha's
Vineyard? About 1,500.
It's a pretty small place.
Yeah, how small is the place you live in?
I live in many places. Smallest in about 2,000 people, but Martha's Vineyard.
What is that?
What about you?
Is that Philadelphia?
This interview is not about me at all. I'm not going to be a YouTube star. Job on that.
Selfish
deputy. Yeah, what is that? What are your responsibilities?
Patrolling
the harbor?
Yep.
Are you armed while you patrol?
No, I don't give a gun. What to do is,
do you have a badge?
Yep.
All badges on selfish deputy.
We have badges on the shirts.
You didn't bring this hat?
Nope.
So if you find someone who doesn't have a permit for selfish deputy,
give them a warning.
Or how would this warning go? You just caught me on a phone.
Next time, bring one, or we're gonna let you try.
They're written anybody a fine?
Nope, they always came back to the penalty.
Because you're so intimidated.
Right? Yep.
What about the baby seal?
Oh, yeah, the baby seal.
I haven't heard this one. Go on, baby seals.
Tell us. Sometimes we get these odd jobs by. That the town wants us to do, and one of them was to be saving like injured baby seal. And we had to go up to it with boards because it was very hostile, and we had to push it into a cage.
Give us an example of what would be your idea.
What might be your idea?